Father, in the name of Jesus, blessed be your name, O Lord, because the earth is the Lord, and everything thereof, the world and we that dwelleth therein. Thank you, Lord God, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that rules in the affair of men. Blessed be your name, O Lord, because even the act of the king is in the hand of the Lord, and he turneth him wheresoever he wants as a river of water. Blessed be your name, O Lord, because all authority in heaven and on earth has been given unto the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be your name, Father, for you have chosen us in this generation to show forth your light. And thank you, Lord God, because that light shines in the midst of darkness, and darkness can never comprehend it. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. I decree to the life of as many that are watching this clip this time around, the powers behind disappointment in your life, let the power die in the name of Jesus Christ. Spirit that is making people to betray you when they're supposed to honor you or appreciate you, I cast that spirit away from your life, I banish them, and I command them to die to the root in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Where you need favor, favor will locate you, and the mercy of God will continue to attend to everything about you in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your name forever. In Jesus' name we pray. We are still on the same topic, idolatry in religion. And to God be the glory, we are in Islamic religion. As I said last week, it's one of the most controversial religions in the world. It's one of the major religions in the world, and it has a lot of adherents. And it matters to us, matters to the people of the world, this time around, especially when terrorism is coming out of that religion. I want to tell you, as many Christians that are watching me, if you fail to pray, if you fail to repent, the Bible says, if my people that are called by my name, if they can humble themselves and call on God, that God will look down and heal our land. Let me tell you, Islamic religion is not something that we just take for granted. It is a religion that every Christian needs to intercede on behalf of some of them that are carried away with fundamentalism, a kind of ideology that's all about destruction. Let me tell you, Christian, if not for God that is even maintaining Christian religion to be at least, the Islamic religion, they have their own way of winning souls. Biologically, they marry many women that gave birth to many children. And under terrorism, a lot of them can overrun any village, any city, any state, any country, that they can force many people to be converted even to that religion. That's all the area we are going. But I just want to tell you, as Christians, you need to be praying for many Muslims so that the light of God will shine into their life, so that they will accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Jesus brought love, and that love must be introduced into their life. We are in that series that we are saying that the God of Islam is different from the God of Christians. Last week said, God of Christians is the God of Israel that introduced himself to the world. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever that believeth in that Son Jesus Christ will not perish but have everlasting life. It is not God that is a sinner, it's a God. The Bible says, why we are yet sinners, the Christ Jesus died for us. If you are not a Muslim, what they know about you is you are a Kafiri. And if you are a Christian, you are in their dangerous list simply because you are committing a sin that is called Sheik. Sheik is that anyone that associates any man or any woman, any personality with their own God has committed Sheik, and the punishment for that sin is death. Now see why you need to be interceding on behalf of as many that are carried with that ideology. Is it the reason why that you need to go out to preach? Don't avoid Muslims whenever you get to any area that you have them. Whether they will listen to you or not, just do your own part. Holy Spirit is the one that do conversion of soul, and he will back you up. But you are waiting till everywhere is overrun by all those terrorists, even you may not enjoy. A day of war can destroy 100 years of achievement. The Lord, we hope you understand, you Christians that are watching me, and you do the right footing. By the grace of God, next week, we check the document of Christian and the document of Islam, which is Bible and the Quran. But I want to say this one, Islam or the Muslim, they have what is called 5 pillars in their religion. The first one is called Sahada. That is to say, they must be confessing that there is no other God except the Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger. In fact, that's the basis of confession. If they want to force anyone to be Muslim, he must be forced to make that pronouncement. And the second one is what is called Salat, prayer. That is to say, they must be praying 5 times in a day. It was 50 that was given to Prophet Muhammad, but through Musa, according to some history, it was reduced to 5. Because he went to Allah, Musa asked him to go back to Allah. That 50 prayer is too much. Allah reduced to 40, reduced it until it reached 5. And they now accept that 5 every day. After that, Salat is, we have Zakat, that is almsgiving. After that, Zakat, we have Sahur, that is fasting at the month of Ramadan, 30 days or 29 days. It all depends on when the moon will come out. Then the last one is Hajj. That is, every Muslim must travel to Mecca once in his or her lifetime. Then the sixth one that is Eden is what is called Jihad. This Jihad, there are some of them that understand it as maybe they should go from place to place to preach Islam. But there are some of them that believe that by fire, by force, everybody in the world must become Muslim. And if you don't want to be a Muslim, you deserve to die. The Lord God will deliver the whole country of the world from every eaters of flesh and drinkers of blood in the name of Jesus. See you next week. God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.